Welcome to number 9 in our series of programmes that looks back at some of the most popular music guests over the last 3 years. It's not often in life you get to meet your heroes, so when I was invited to meet folk legend Julie Felix, Kirsty Hannah and I jumped in the car and drove with great excitement and some trepidation to a music studio where Julie was resting after a gig the previous night. Julie was charming, fascinating and full of life as she spoke about her music, missions and the amazing people who had populated her life. It was to be the last interview Julie gave before she died in March this year. This is our tribute to the girl from Santa Barbara, California, who in the 1960s brought folk music into popular culture, paving the way for a generation of folk singers that followed. So, Julie, thanks for joining us on Billboard today. You first came to England in the 60s, 1964?
Yeah, I think I actually came in 63, and my first album was released in 64.
Okay.
And I was the first folk singer to sign with a major label. So yeah. So that sort of like opened up the future.
The whole world of folk for people, yeah. Mm. Yeah. I think one of your early influences, not so much for your music, but your lifestyle, was some of the beat poets, like Jack Kerouac.
Yeah, I mean, that was why I kind of wanted to travel. It was definitely Jack Kerouac on the road that influenced me to just go and taste life.
Rather be a hammer than a nail. Yes, I would.
On your travels, you also met someone who I think became a lifelong friend, and that's Leonard Cohen.
Yeah. I was just thinking. Apparently, there's just a film that's come out about Marianne and Leonard. Mm. And I know they came and interviewed me once, but I didn't know if it was part of the thing or not, but my friends wrote me and said that, yeah, I am part. So I'm really touched because Marianne was a dear friend of mine as well.
Yeah.
And to lose them both in the same year was really devastating.
Yeah. Like the shoreline and the sea, but let's not talk of love or change, things we can't untie. Also, before your own show, you were part of probably the most avant-garde piece of television at the time with David Frost. We're going to the zoo. How about you can come too. We're going. And after your success during the 60s and 70s and early 80s with an album every year and various singles, you stopped.
Yeah, I got a bit fed up with the sort of commercial side of everything.
Mm.
And so I stopped singing and I went back to California for a while.
Mm.
And I got involved with yoga and meditation, those things of sort of soul searching, you know.
Mm. Mm.
And then I decided there was still a lot to sing about. So I came back to England and started singing.
So how do you view the world now compared with the world as it was in the 60s when we grew up?
Well, there was a lot more optimism in the 60s. In the 60s, we were concerned we wanted to change the world. Mm. Now I just go, oh my God, you know, what's going to happen?
Mm.
And I mean, I'm still singing and still praying and still doing my rituals to try to bring good energy into the world.
Well, Julie, you're a great inspiration to people of my generation that grew up with you when you were in the 60s, and a great inspiration to the new generation of young people and folk singers. Thanks for joining us on Billboard. It's a sound.
If I only could, I surely would. I'd rather be a hammer than a nail.
Yes, I would. If I only could, I surely would. Away, I'd rather sail away like a swan that's here and gone. A man gets tired to the ground, he gives the world its saddest sound, its saddest sound. I'd rather be a forest than a street. Yes, I would. If I could, I surely would. I'd rather feel the earth beneath my feet. Yes, I would. If I only could, I surely would. Oh, man gets tired to the ground, he gives the world its saddest sound, its saddest sound.